So good morning students, in this video we will discuss another part of energy flow, that is small important topics food chain and food web. The first one is food chain. What is food chain? It is a sequence of populations or organisms which are connected through food at various trophic levels. It is a sequence of populations or organisms which are connected through food at various trophic levels is known as food chain. And the food chain has specific characters. So what are the important characteristics of food chain? So food chain usually it consists of sequence of population, and usually food chains are always straight. And each food chain has 3 to 6 trophic levels. And food chains are usually sustained by producers and decomposers. Because producers make the food material through the process of photosynthesis, and the dead parts of plants and animals are decomposed by decomposers. That's why all the types of food chains are sustained by producers and decomposers. And in food chains, some organisms like humans, they can operate at more than one trophic levels. Sometimes they act as herbivores and sometimes they act as carnivores. And here, so there is a decrease in the available biomass. While it passes from one trophic level to another trophic level. So these are the some important characteristic features of food chains. And food chains are usually three types. What are the three types? Parasitic food chain, detritus food chain and grazing food chain. The first one is parasitic food chain. It is also known as PFC, parasitic food chain. And parasitic food chain usually begins with host and usually it ends in parasite. That's why it is also known as parasitic food chain is also known as auxiliary food chain. Because it begins with host and generally ends in parasite. For example, producer. So producer become a host and parasite is parasitic organism. This is one type of parasitic food chain. And one more is herbivore and parasite and carnivore and parasite. Usually it begins with host and ends in parasite. So this type of food chain is called parasitic food chains. Parasitic food chains, they do not have fixed any trophic levels since they feed on all kinds of organisms. So it is also known as parasitic food chain is also known as auxiliary food chain. And second one is detritus food chain. So detritus food chain commonly is DFC. Detritus food chain. And detritus food chain is usually it begins with detritus. What is detritus? Already I told you. So the remains of dead organic matter is known as detritus. And usually detritivores feed on detritus. Detritivores, the organisms which feed on detritus is known as detritivores. And it begins detritus food chain. It begins with detritus in terrestrial ecosystems. DFC is the major conduit of energy flow. That means the large amount of energy transferred through detritus food chain. And detritus food chain is often connected with grazing food chain. One example for detritus food chain, that is, it begins with detritus and earthworm. So earthworm is one of the important detritivore, and sparrow and peacock. So it is the one of the food chain of detritus. Detritus food chain. One of the example for detritus food chain. Detritus. So earthworm feed on detritus, sparrow feed on earthworm, and peacock feed on sparrow. And sometimes it is also connected with grazing food chain. So earthworm is fed upon by a frog, feed on earthworm, then snake, and again it is falcon. So it is the one kind of detritus food chain. In terrestrial ecosystems, a large amount of energy transferred through detritus food chain, and it is often connected with grazing food chain. And last one is grazing food chain. So grazing food chain is also called GFC. GFC means grazing food chain. So it is the most common food chain in aquatic ecosystems. In aquatic ecosystems, it is the major conduit of energy transfer or energy flow. So grazing food chain is also known as predator food chain. Predator food chain, as predator occurs at every step. At every step predator occurs, that's why grazing food chain is also known as predator. It is also known as predator food chain. And this predator food chain or grazing food chain has different composition. And what are the components of grazing food chain? The components of grazing food chain are producers, herbivores, primary carnivores or herbivores, and all they are called consumers. They are directly known as consumers and decomposers. These are the main components of grazing food chain. The first component is producers. So as you know, what are producers? Producers are usually they are autotrophic organisms. When they are autotrophic organisms, they make their own food through the process of photosynthesis. For photosynthesis, they possess chlorophylls. And in this process, oxygen is also evolved. Already in class 11, already we will discuss about photosynthesis. What is the equation of photosynthesis? 6CO2 plus 12H2O give rise to C6H12O6 plus 6 molecules of oxygen for this sunlight and chlorophyll required. So this is the process of photosynthesis. With the help of photosynthesis, producers can make their own food through the process of photosynthesis. That's why producers are also called transducers, because they convert radiant energy into chemical energy. And some of the producers are green plants, phytoplankton, some members of monera, and some members of protists. So it is called producers. Next, consumers. And consumers are various types. The first type of consumers are herbivores. Herbivores are first order consumer. They are first order consumer, and usually they feed on producers or plant species. Herbivores feed on plant species or plant parts. That's why herbivores are also called key industry animals, because they convert plant matter. Because they convert plant matter into animal matter. That's why herbivores are also called key industry animals. And herbivores are first order consumers which feed on plants or plant products. They are also known as key industry animals because they convert plant matter into animal matter. And second one, next one is primary carnivores. Primary carnivores. Primary carnivores, usually they feed on herbivorous animals. They ingest or prey upon herbivorous animals. For example, some of the examples are snake or frog. These are the some of the examples. And next, secondary carnivores usually feed on primary carnivores. They are larger size herbivorous, they are larger size consumer organisms, and usually heterotrophic organisms which they feed on primary carnivores. For example, one more example is wolf. And the next one is top carnivores. So top carnivores are usually they feed on secondary carnivores. they do not prey upon by any other organisms because they are larger size and they have most agility and they are also stronger than remaining organisms. That's why they are the top carnivores, usually feed upon primary or secondary carnivores. Example, lion, tiger. So these are some of the examples which are placed under top carnivores. And next one is decomposers. And decomposers are usually they are feed on dead decaying matter or they feed on detritus. Usually they feed on detritus. Detritus, and they are also one of the important trophic levels which make the food chain. So these are the some important components of food chain. Now we will see some examples of food chain. Aquatic ecosystems and terrestrial ecosystem. If you take terrestrial ecosystem, there are number of ecosystems and each ecosystem has its own food chain and food web. One example is, for example, if you observe grassland, then grass is the producer, then grasshopper feed on grass, then frog feed on insect, then snake, then falcon. So this is the one of the food chain of terrestrial ecosystems. And if you observe aquatic ecosystems, then food chain, one of the food chain is phytoplanktons, because phytoplanktons are the primary producers in aquatic ecosystem. So zooplanktons, next they are placed under herbivorous animals. Next, small crustaceans, primary carnivores. Next, predator. Next one is small fishes, secondary carnivores, larger fishes, and crocodile. So this is the one of the food chain of aquatic ecosystems. So what is food chain? It is a sequence of populations. It is a sequence of populations which are connected through food at various trophic levels. And food chains are usually sustained by both producers and decomposers. And food chains are, they are simple. A simple straight food chains present in nature generally. And next one is food web. So what is food web? If you observe this schematic diagram, this is vegetation. So this is primary producer. Rabbit, mouse, and deer. And this one is jackal, wolf, tiger. This is the top carnivore. And here, fox. And here, wildcat. Here is wildcat. This is the food web. So what is food web? It is interconnected of, or it is the network of food chains. This is one food chain, this is one food chain, this is one food chain, this is one food chain. It is the network of food chains which become interconnected at different trophic levels, which provides alternate source of food for biotic community. So food chains are simple, straight. But food webs are, so what is food web? It is a network of food chains. It is a network of food chains which become interconnected at various trophic levels. That is known as food web. So it is simply, it is a group of food chains. Group of food chains which become interconnected at various trophic levels through food material, that is known as food web. And this food web also has some important characteristics. So what are important characters? Food web is more real. Food web is more real than food chains because food web provides alternate source of food. It provides alternate source of food. If you follow food chain, so food chains are straight. For example, phytoplankton, zooplankton. So phytoplankton is absent, then zooplankton always. It is not survive in that particular ecosystem. But food web, for example, rabbit, for example, rabbit, or if you take a fox, fox usually feed upon both rabbit and mouse. If rabbit is available, then it feed on rabbit. If rabbit is not available, then fox obviously it feed on mouse. That's why food web is more real than food chain. So food web provides alternate source of food, and it is not straight. Food webs are not straight. They are interlinked. They become interlinked at various trophic levels. And what is the importance of food web? And food webs are usually, they are maintained according to taste and food preference. And however, sometimes the availability of food also becomes more important. If you, for example, in Sundarbans reserves, tiger usually feed upon deer. If deer is not available, then tiger feed on wildcat. Then if wildcat is available, then availability of food also becomes important. And food webs are usually maintained according to taste of food, preference of food. But sometimes the availability of food also becomes important. So food webs are more real than food chains. So these are the two important topics in energy flow.